السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. I welcome our dear brothers and sisters in Al-Islam. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. Your brother in Islam, Bilal Ismail of the Al-Kawthar Institute and Imam Development Project, with you for another majlis of ilm, another majlis of dhikr, another majlis of us learning and understanding the Arabic language. Why? Because we want to understand the noble Quran. We want to understand the sunnah of our Habib, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We've understood that Arabic in reality is the language of Al-Islam, walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, in our previous majlis, we completed lesson number 23 of book 2, walhamdulillah. In this majlis, we move on to lesson number 24. Lesson number 24, a very short lesson, inshaAllah. What does it summarize? It summarizes all the number forms that we've already covered so far in these lessons, walhamdulillah. From the time we were in book 1 up to this point, every number, every type of form of number that we've come across, we will revise them now in this lesson, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. We will remind ourselves with regards to the rules that we have learned, walhamdulillah. And so it's a revision lesson with regards to al-adad. Al-adad, adad meaning numbers, insha'Allah. So if we open up, we find that the author states, طالبٌ واحدٌ, طالبٌ واحدٌ, one student. What if it's a female student? طالبةٌ واحدةٌ, طالبةٌ واحدةٌ. Notice, واحدٌ and واحدةٌ, they came after that which was being counted. And they came as an adjective. Similarly with regards to two. طالباني إثناني. إثناني came after طالباني. And with regards to two female students, طالبتاني إثنتاني. Take note. واحد and إثناني, they came after whatever was being counted and they came in the form of an adjective describing word. واحدة and إثنتاني, the same inshaAllah. So the rule is what? The rule is that with regards to one and two, the number is in agreement with the ma'dud, with what is being counted. Whatever is being counted is masculine, the number will be masculine. Whatever is being counted is feminine, the number will be feminine. And the number comes after the ma'dud and it agrees with the ma'dud in all respects. I mean, here it is coming in the form of an adjective, and so it agrees with the item being counted in all respects, insha'Allah. Remember that. With regards to one and two, they agree with the ma'dud. طالبٌ واحدٌ, طالبةٌ واحدةٌ, طالبان إثنان, طالبتان إثنتان. Technically, when we say طالبان, we don't need to say إثنان, because it's understood from طالبان that it means two students. طالبتاني, it's understood that it means two female students, walhamdulillah. But from 3 to 10, this is when we work on the opposites, insha'Allah, work on the opposites with regards to the number. If what is being counted is masculine, our number will be feminine. If what's being counted is feminine, our number will be masculine, insha'Allah. Let's see. ثلاثة طلاب, ثلاثة طلاب, ثلاثة طلاب, feminine, ثلاث طالبات, ثلاث طالبات. So with regards to the adad, the number, it works on the opposites. It works on the opposites. And take note, with regards to the ma'dud, what is being counted, it's in the plural form and it is It is majrurified. It is mudafun ilay. It is in the form of majrur. It is kasrafied, insha'Allah. Let's read. Thalathatu tulabin. Thalathu talibatin. Arba'atu tulabin. Arba'u talibatin. Khamsatu tulabin. Khamsu talibatin. Sittatu tulabin. Sittu talibatin. سبعة طلاب سبع طالبات ثمانية طلاب ثماني طالبات تسعة طلاب تسع طالبات عشرة طلاب عشر طالبات والحمد لله. We've covered 1 to 10. 1 and 2 agree with what's been counted. 3 to 10 work on the opposites, insha'Allah. Excellent. Walhamdulillah. Let's look at number 11 and 12. Number 11 and 12 will be just like 1 and 2 in that they will agree, insha'Allah. Let's see. Ahada ashara taliban. We are counting 11. We are counting 11 students. Ahada ashara taliban. Ahada Ashara Taliban. Taliban is masculine and our number Ahada Ashara also masculine. But take note here, now when it comes to 11 and above, our Ma'dud, what we've been counted, what we're counting, is no longer in the plural form. It's in the singular form. Ahada Ashara Taliban. Not Ahada Ashara Tulaban. No. Ahada Ashara Taliban. Feminine. إحدى عشرة طالبة إحدى عشرة طالبة إثنى عشرة طالبا إثنتا عشرة طالبة 11 and 12 agree with the معدود inshallah. And then as for the معدود itself, it's in the singular form and it's منسوب. Singular form and it is منسوب. 13. ثلاثة عشر طالبا. Operating on the opposites. طالبان masculine. So now we have ثلاثة. 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 Feminine. ثلاثة عشر طالبا. ثلاثة عشرة طالبة. 14. أربعة عشر طالبا. أربعة عشرة طالبة. خمسة عشر طالبا. خمسة عشرة طالبة. Please read with us, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah. Sittata ashara taliban. Sitta ashrata talibatan. Sab'ata ashara taliban. Sab'a ashrata talibatan. Thamaniyata ashara taliban. Thamaniya ashrata talibatan. Tis'ata ashara taliban. Tis'a ashrata talibatan. And then it changes at 20. Ishruna taliban. Ishruna taliban. And ishruna talibatan. Walhamdulillah. When it comes to 30, 40, 50, ishrun, etc., here the gender is not affected. Ishruna taliban. Ishruna talibatan. Walhamdulillah. MashaAllah. Excellent. So we saw from 13 to 20. 13 to 19 rather, we operate on the opposites, insha'Allah. And we apply the same rule with regards to all numbers after that. For example, 21. Wahidun wa ishruna taliban. Wahidun agrees with taliban in gender. Wahidun wa ishruna taliban. Ihda wa ishruna talibatan. إثناني وعشرون طالبا إثنتاني وعشرون طالبة. Then the opposites. ثلاثة وعشرون طالبا ثلاث وعشرون طالبة أربعة وعشرون طالبا أربع وعشرون طالبة خمسة وعشرون طالبا خمس وعشرون طالبة ستة وعشرون طالبا ست وعشرون طالبة سبعة وعشرون طالبا سبع وعشرون طالبة ثمانية وعشرون طالبا ثمان وعشرون طالبة. With regards to number 8, we will learn more about this in book 3 inshallah. تسعة وعشرون طالبا تسع وعشرون طالبة والحمد لله. Then 30 طالبا 30 طالبة 40 طالبا 40 طالبة 50 طالبا 50 طالبة 60 طالبا 60 طالبة 70 طالبا 70 طالبة 80 طالبا 80 طالبة 90 طالبا 90 طالبة. Excellent. Walhamdulillah. And then mi'atu talibin. Look different. Mi'atu talibin. Mi'atu talibin. Mudaf mudafun ilayhi. Mi'atu talibin. Mi'atu talibatin. Mi'atu talibin. Mi'atu talibatin. So the rule here is that with regards to the ma'adud, whatever we are counting, when it's 3 to 10, when it's 3 to 10, it's in the plural form and then it's majroor. أربعة طلاب plural مجرور. Then from 11 to 99 it's in the singular form and it's منصوب. سبعة عشر طالبا. And then 100,000 etc. That's when it goes in the singular form and it becomes مجرور. مئة طالب مئة طالبة مئة طالب وطا مئة طالب وطالب 101 مئة طالب وطالب 100 students and a student مئة طالبة وطالبة 100 students and a student مئة طالب وطالبان 100 students and two students مئة طالبة وطالبتان 102 students مئة وثلاثة طلاب. Take note. مئة 100. وثلاثة طلاب. Just like how we've already learned. وثلاثة طلاب and three students. مئة وثلاث طالبات. مئة وأربعة طلاب. 104 students. مئة وأربع طالبات. مئة وخمسة طلاب مئة وخمس طالبات مئة وستة طلاب مئة وست طالبات. Continues like that. Let's move to 110. مئة وعشرة طلاب مئة وعشر طالبات. Excellent. Then مئة وأحد عشر طالبا 111 مئة وأحد عشر طالبا مئة وإحدى عشرة طالبة. We're just adding the word مئة and it's operating the same as we previously learned. مئتان. What's مئتان? مئتان means 200. Then when we have the معدود, when we have مئتان or we have ألفان 2000 and we also mention the ma'dud, then what happens is we drop the ending. It becomes mi'ata talibin. Mi'ata talibin, 200 students. Mi'ata talibatin, 200 students. Thalathu mi'ati talibin, 300 students. Thalathu mi'ati talibatin, 400 students. أربعة مئة طالب. أربع مئة طالبة. خمس مئة طالب. خمس مئة طالب. خمس مئة طالبة. ست مئة طالب. ست مئة طالبة. سبعمائة طالب سبعمائة طالبة. Doesn't change. ثمانمائة طالب ثمانمائة طالب and ثمانمائة طالبة. تسعمائة طالب تسعمائة طالبة والحمد لله. ألف طالب just like 100. ألف طالبتين. ألفاني 200. And same when we have or rather 2000. 2000, ألفاني 2000. And if we mention the معدود, then the معدود becomes the معدود is majrurified and the number we drop the noon inshallah. ألفا طالبين. ألفا طالبتين. ثلاثة آلاف طالب. ثلاثة آلاف طالب. 3,000 students. ثلاثة آلاف طالبة. 3,000 students, female students. أربعة آلاف طالب. أربعة آلاف طالب. أربعة آلاف طالبة. خمسة آلاف طالب. خمسة آلاف طالبة. ستة آلاف طالب. ستة آلاف طالبة. سبعة آلاف طالب. سبعة آلاف طالبة. ثمانية آلاف طالب. ثمانية آلاف طالبة. And it continues like that. Let's move to 20,000. عشرون ألف طالب. عشرون ألف طالب. عشرون ألف طالبة. ثلاثون ألف طالب. ثلاثون ألف طالبة. أربعون ألف طالب. أربعون ألف طالبة. خمسون ألف طالب. خمسون ألف طالبة. ما شاء الله. مئة ألف طالب. 100,000. مئة ألف طالبة. مئتا ألف طالب. 200,000. مئتا ألف طالبة. ثلاثمائة ألف طالب. 300,000 students. أربعمائة ألف طالب. أربعمائة ألف طالبة. Let's read this number 6,543. ثلاثة وأربعون. So we begin the opposite. We begin at the end. ثلاثة وأربعون. 3 and 40. 43. ثلاثة وأربعون. وخمسمائة and 500. وستة آلاف ريال. وستة آلاف ريال. وستة آلاف ريال. And 6,000 reals. Reals is masculine. And so our numbers were feminine. Now let's see if we're counting something feminine. روبية. ثلاث وأربعون. وخمسمائة وستة. ستة آلاف روبية. ثلاث وأربعون. 3 and 40, 43. وخمسمائة and 500, 543. وستة آلاف and ستة آلاف and 6,000 روبية. والحمد لله. Then they give us the rules inshallah. أحوال العدد. The different states of the number. العددان واحد واثنان. The two numbers 1 and 2 على وفق المعدود. They agree with what's being counted. They agree with the معدود. They match the معدود. Number 2. الأعداد من ثلاثة إلى عشرة. The numbers from 3 to 10 على عكس المعدود are the opposite of the item counted. Opposite of the معدود. العددان أحد عشر واثنى عشر. The two numbers 11 and 12. الجزآن على وفق المعدود. The two parts are in agreement with the معدود. الجزآن على وفق المعدود are in agreement with the item being counted. الأعداد من ثلاثة عشر إلى تسعة عشر. From 13, from 13 to 19. الجزء الأول على عكس المعدود. The first part of the number is in the opposite of what's been counted. And the second part is in agreement. It matches. As for the معدود, what's being counted, from 3 to 10, example, طلاب, it is plural and it is majrurified, kasrafied. From 11 to 99, it's like طالبان. It is singular and mansub. 100, 1,000, 3,000, 10,000, طالبين. It is singular and it's مجرور. والحمد لله. يا عبد الله, يا أمة الله. و With that, we have completed lesson number 24, short lesson, revision with regards to all of the numbers that we've already taken. Walhamdulillah, masha'Allah, tabarakallah. And so, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, we move on to lesson number 25, insha'Allah. Let's read the passage. But before that, what will we be covering in lesson number 25? Lesson number 25, we've already been introduced to kana. Kana, we were introduced to kana in lesson number 6. What does kana mean? Kana means, it was or he was. Kana al-ma'u baridan. The water was cold. Al-ma'u baridun. Originally, put kana in front. Kana al-ma'u baridan. We say that al-ma'u is what we call ism kana. It's marfu'. And the khabar kana, it is mansub. It has the fatha, masha'Allah. Kana al-ma'u baridan. Kana al-jawu jamilan. The weather was beautiful. Kana al-jawu jamilan. Kana al-jawu jamilan. So the opposite of inna. Inna makes the word after it mansub. Inna allaha ghafurun. Whereas kana the opposite. Kana allahu ghafuran. Inna allaha ghafurun. Opposite with kana. Kana allahu ghafuran, etc. Jamil. But if, for example, our khabar, if it's like a preposition, fil fasli, then it remains unchanged. Example, kana al-mudarrisu fil fasli. Here we cannot mansubify fil fasli, so it remains unchanged. Kana al-mudarrisu fil fasli. We will also cover in this lesson a sister of kana, la yazalu. La yazalu, he is still. La yazalu bilalun maridan. La yazalu bilalun maridan. Bilal is still sick. So originally we had bilalun maridun. Bilalun maridun. Bilal is sick. La yazalu bilalun maridan. Bilal is still sick. Bilal is still sick. We've already learned about qabla and ba'da. Ba'da al-masjidi, qabla al-adhani, qabla al-salati, qabla al-fajri, etc. We know that, walhamdulillah. But just to remember, if we do not mention the mudafun ilay, if the mudafun ilay is left out, then it is qablu and it is ba'du. Lillahi al-amru min qablu wa min ba'du. So the mudafun ilay is left out. So we don't say بعد الصلاة and قبل الفجر with the fatha, etc. Here it can take a dhamma, insha'Allah, because there's no mudafun ilay mentioned. We will also learn about diptotes and some of their plurals, insha'Allah, words which are diptotes in the plural form. مريضٌ sick. But in its plural form, it is مرضى, diptotes. أسيرٌ prisoner. In its plural form, it is asra. That's a diptote. Ahmaq. You know somebody who's an idiot. Plural, hamqa. That word hamqa is a diptote, whereas the singular is not. Qatilun. The one who's killed. Qatilun. Qatla. Qatla is the plural, and that plural there is a diptote, insha'Allah. Let's read the passage, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. الدرس الخامس والعشرون المدرس أين أنور يا عمر أين أنور يا عمر لا أدري I don't know where's أنور أو عمر I don't know لا أدري لا أدري لا أدري means I don't know أدري means I know لا أدري I don't know رأيته قبل قليل I saw him a short while ago قبل قليل كان واقفا كَانَ وَاقِفًا كَانَ وَاقِفًا He was standing خَارِجَ الْفَصْلِ كَانَ وَاقِفًا خَارِجَ الْفَصْلِ كَانَ وَاقِفًا خَارِجَ الْفَصْلِ You might ask, well, didn't we just learn after كَانَ, the ism كَانَ, it will be مَرْفُوع form. كَانَ
then something, and then will be mansub. Yes, but in this sentence here, the ism kana is mustatir. It's not mentioned. Huwa, it's not mentioned. We're talking about, let's say we mention the guy's name, then we would say, kana anwaru waqifan. But we didn't mention his name. Right? It's understood. Kana anwaru waqifan. It's understood. Kana anwaru waqifan. Kharij al-fasli. He was standing outside the classroom. Al-mudarrisu. Kayfa halu ammarin al-ana ya sa'adu. How is Ammar now, O Sa'ad? Kana maridan. He was sick. Same story here. Who are we talking about? We're talking about Ammar. Kana ammarun. مريضاً if we want to mention his name. كان عمار مريضاً منذ أسبوع since a week. سعد says لا يزال مريضاً he is still sick. لا يزال مريضاً sister of كان لا يزال لا يزال عمار مريضاً if we had to mention his name. لا يزال عمار مريضاً لا يزال عمار مريضا يا فضيلة الشيخ سمعت أنه يريد I heard that he wants أن يترك المستشفى he wants to leave the hospital ترك يترك means to leave أن يترك المستشفى after أن يترك المستشفى ويرجع أن يترك المستشفى ويرجع إلى بيته ويرجع إلى بيته. I heard that he wants to leave the hospital ويرجع إلى بيته and return to his home. أصحيح هذا? Is this correct? Is this true? سعد says لا هذا غير صحيح. هذا غير صحيح. This is not true. ماذا يعمل أبوك يا إبراهيم؟ ماذا يعمل أبوك يا إبراهيم؟ What does your father do, O Ibrahim? سمعت أنه وزير. سمعت أنه وزير. I heard that he is a minister. كان وزيرا. كان وزيرا. He was a minister قبل سنتين. 2 years ago. كان أبي وزيرا. My father was a minister قبل سنتين. وهو الآن سفير. And he is now an ambassador. وماذا يعمل أبوك يا عمر? What does your father do, O Amr? قال لي أحد زملائك. Said to me one of your colleagues. إنه مدرس. That indeed he is a teacher. Amr says, كان مدرسا. He was a teacher. كان مدرسا. Same story again here. We're not mentioning the person's name. It's مستتر. It is understood. But remember, if we had to bring his name there, let's say for example, his name was Muhammad. كان محمد مدرسا من قبل. من قبل. He was a teacher before. وهو الآن موجه. And he is now a موجه, a counselor. في المدارس الثانوية. In the secondary schools. موجه. He is a counselor. وماذا يعمل أبوك يا يعقوب? What does your father do, O يعقوب? كان شرطيا. He was a policeman. شرطيا. وهو الآن متقاعد. وهو الآن متقاعد. And he is now retired. متقاعد. He is now retired. يا أبا بكر. قلت لي قبل 3 سنوات. You said to me 3 years ago. قلت لي قبل 3 سنوات. You said to me before 3 years ago or 3 years ago, إن أباك عميد, that indeed your father عميد كلية الهندسة, he is the dean of the faculty of engineering. أمتقاعد هو الآن, is he now retired? لا لا يزال عميدا. لا لا يزال عميدا. No, he is still the dean. يا أختر سمعت أن أخاك I heard that your brother, طبيب شهير, is a famous doctor. ويأتيه المرضى, and comes to him patients, sick people, من جميع أنحاء باكستان, from all over Pakistan. أصحيح هذا? Is this correct? نعم هذا صحيح يا فضيلة الشيخ. يا فضيلة الشيخ. يا عثمان. اذهب إلى المكتبة, go to the library, وهات الجزء الثالث, and bring volume 3 من لسان العربي, of لسان العرب. يا فضيلة الشيخ, أظن أن لسان العربي معجم. I think that لسان العرب is a dictionary. نعم, هو معجم كبير. Yes, it is a dictionary. في 20 جزءا. في 20 جزءا, in 20 volumes. لمن هو يا فضيلة الشيخ? By who is it, O فضيلة الشيخ? هو لابن منظور. It is by Ibn Manzoor. يرجع عثمان. عثمان returns. المكتبة مغلقة الآن يا شيخ. The library is closed now, O شيخ. يقولون إنها كانت. They say that it was مفتوحة, it was open, إلى أذان الظهر, until the أذان of ظهر. إلى أذان الظهر, until the أذان of ظهر. يا عباس, قل لأخيك, say to your brother, الذي يدرس, who is studying, في السنة الثانية, in the second year, يأتيني, should come to me, he should come to me غدا, he should come to me tomorrow. سأقول له إن شاء الله, I will say to him, إن شاء الله, I will say to him, if Allah wills, والحمد لله, ما شاء الله تبارك الله. Let's see if we can cover some of the questions, inshallah, at least exercise 1, maybe exercise 2, inshallah. Exercise 1, comprehension questions. أين كان أنور واقفا? أين كان أنور واقفا? أين كان أنور واقفا? See? كان أنور واقفا. كان أنور واقفا خارج الفصل. كان أنور واقفا خارج الفصل. Correct. أيريد عمار أن يترك المستشفى? Does Ammar want to leave the hospital? لا. هو ما يريد أن يترك. Does he want to leave the hospital? They said no, that was not true. So they said that was not true. أيريد عمار أن يترك المستشفى? لا. هو لا يريد أن يترك المستشفى. 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 He does not want to leave the hospital. Number 3. من الذي أبوه سفير? Whose father is the ambassador? Whose father? إبراهيم. هو إبراهيم. هو إبراهيم. Number 4. من الذي أبوه شرطي متقاعد? And whose father is the retired policeman? هو يعقوب. هو يعقوب. من ذهب إلى المكتبة? Who went to the library? عثمان ذهب إلى المكتبة. من ألف لسان العربي? Who wrote لسان العرب? ألفه ابن منظور. ألفه ابن منظور رحمه الله تعالى. في كم جزءا هو? In how many volumes is it? هو في 20 جزءا. هو في 20 جزءا. أكانت المكتبة مفتوحة? أكانت المكتبة مفتوحة? أكانت المكتبة مفتوحة? أكانت المكتبة مفتوحة? لا, كانت مغلقة. لا, كانت مغلقة. No, it was closed. No, it was closed. Exercise number 2. Add كان to the following sentences. حامد مريض الآن. كان حامد مريضا أمس. كان حامد مريضا أمسي زينب طالبة كانت زينب طالبة كانت زينب طالبة الماء بارد كان الماء باردا الباب مفتوح كان الباب كان الباب مفتوحا النافذة مغلقة كانت النافذة مغلقة كانت النافذة مغلقة مغلقة كانت النافذة مغلقة هشام مدرس كان هشام مدرسا الرجل نصراني كان الرجل نصرانيا الجو بارد كان الجو باردا المدير جالس في غرفته كان المدير جالسا في غرفته هذه الساعة رخيصة هذه الساعة رخيصة كانت هذه الساعة رخيصة كانت هذه الساعة رخيصة عمر رجل غني كان عمر رجلا غنيا and the last one عمنا مدير مدرسة عمنا مدير مدرسة كان عمنا مدير مدرسة كان عمنا مدير مدرسة مدير مدرسة مدير مدرسة كان عمنا مدير مدرسة excellent والحمد لله and they explain to us there حامد طالب we call this حامد the مبتدا our subject we call طالب our خبر our predicate our information then when we add كان كان حامد we call حامد now اسم كان كان حامد طالبا طالبا خبر كان اسم كان is مرفوع ضم فاعل and خبر كان is منسوب فاعل إن شاء الله والحمد لله يا عبد الله يا أمة الله we will stop the Arabic there إن شاء الله and we will continue from that point in our next majlis بإذن الله تعالى a prophetic hadith which in reality is a قاعدة is a maxim we find the famous hadith of the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم states that إنما الطاعة في المعروف that obedience is in that which is permissible, that which is allowed. You're not allowed to obey somebody in that which is haram. We find the famous hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam put somebody in charge of these companions who were out on a journey, and then there was some issue between them. So the Amir, he told them to gather the firewood together. They gathered it. And then he asked them to start a fire. They did so. Then he orders them to jump into it. And they said, no. He says, but didn't the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say to you people that you people should obey me? And so you are supposed to get into the fire. Eventually, when they come back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they complain about this Amir, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that if they entered into that fire, they would not exit from it. And indeed, obedience is in accordance to the ma'roof, that which is permissible, that which is allowed. You're not allowed to obey somebody in that which is haram, that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden. Allahu musta'an. So, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, this is with regards to, you know, your father, with regards to your mother, with regards to the ruler, with regards to the mayor, with regards to anyone who has authority over you, that you obey them, obedience to them, in that which is allowed, that which is permissible, walhamdulillah. But if they order you to do something which is haram, then there is no ta'a, there is no obedience to them in that which is haram. How can you be obedient to them in that which is haram? And then technically you are now disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu musta'an. And so as many a scholar has stated, let's say for example, the mother, she says to you that divorce your wife. And there's no issue with your wife. There's no problem with your wife. But your mother dislikes her because of whatever reason. If your mother is not justified in this matter. You do not have to obey your mother in this matter. And same with the father, etc. Allahu musta'an, Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, ya Amat Allah. Some words bi'idhnillahi ta'ala from our vocab, insha'Allah. We covered, for example, the word tajirun, businessman. We talked about taraka. Taraka means to leave. We continue. Mut'abun. Mut'abun, the brother says, I am very mut'abun. Mut'abun means I am tired, I am weary. You say to somebody, ta'al. Ta'al huna, come here. Ta'al means come here. Tufahun, an apple. Tilfazun, television. Tilfazun, television. Tilmidhun, student, pupil. Tilawatun, recitation. Tala yatlu, tuluwan means to follow, to ensue. Tala means to follow or to ensue. Su'al is example. As-su'alu tali, the following question. Su'alu tali, following question. Tamma, tamaman means to complete something or to become complete. Tamun, something which is complete. Walhamdulillah. Then, for example, we have the word atamma. Atamma means to complete something, to make something complete. Itmaman. Somebody says, for example, taba yatubu tawbatan. This is tawbah, when one repents, turns back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taba al-abdu ila Allah, the man has turned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Excellent. Teen, what is teen? Teen is the fig, jayid. Teen. Teen is the watini wa zaytun, by the fig and the zaytun. Walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, ya Amat Allah, this is where we will end off this majlis. We ask Allah to grant us barakah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the best in this world and in the hereafter. We ask Allah to protect the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us within our lifetimes, a new dawn, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy, rahmah, and to forgive our mistakes. Hada wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala abdihi wa rasulihi nabiyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Until we meet again, your brother in Islam, Bilal Ismail. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.